Glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Deep in the Sunshine State, FIU Stadium in Miami is the site. Players have returned to the field, putting the final touches on their warm-up. Fans getting settled into their seats, just about set for kickoff from FIU Stadium. That does it for us here on the NCAA College Football Pregame Show. Enjoy the game. We'll see you at the half.
At FIU Stadium, home to the Golden Panthers.
Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
Both teams are lining up for the kickoff, and we're just about set to get this one underway. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 30. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Side, and there's nothing going there.
The defense was playing run all the way right there, and it paid off for them.
Second and 13, ball on the 27. And they'll get him in the backfield.
The Cowboys always have guys that are near the top statistically, and that's no exception today. We're really looking forward to watching this kid play.
Third down and what they didn't want to get in. Ball on the 20. He's got room inside the 30, and he hits him hard at the 28-yard line.
You know, they did a great job here of not just getting past a first down marker, but picking up some major yards on the play.
They keep it on the ground with the tailback. Defense says they've got it, and they do.
You love to see your playmakers on defense coming through and creating some breaks, which is exactly what the safety did.
So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Caught out in the open. He's taken down around the 48-yard line.
One of the more difficult plays to defend. The defense went after the quarterback, which left the running back with plenty of room.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That brings him second and five. third down, and they need to get it to the 28.
He goes out of bounds at the 32-yard line. Under heavy pressure. Tackle
at about the 29-yard line.
And they'll fail on fourth down. The offense couldn't hang on to the ball last time around. Let's see what happens here.
Sometimes when you lose the football, you start to focus a little bit more. So a turnover can actually work out in your favor.
And he's sacked.
Man, these guys can be aggressive. When you stand back there and take hits like that, you definitely are going to feel it the next day.
So the sack makes this a second and long. He's out to the 30. Excellent open field tackle.
Call it a gain of 11 yards. That'll bring up third and six.
Catches it, and he's immediately tackled behind the line. And they back up 3 yards on that play.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
That'll make it fourth and 10.
Holly is the punter. He makes it out to midfield. Not a bad return. And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter.
The Cowboys saw one of their top players going down earlier, but looks like he's going to be able to get back in there.
He's at the 40. Makes it out to about the 36.
You like to see a team having success like this running the football. It can really open up things for the offense.
He's on the run. Dives forward. Good gain there on the quarterback scramble.
You know, I really like the decision to tuck it and run here. He waited and found no one open, so instead of throwing it away, he just took it upfield for himself.
Mike 56.
Carries it again, and he's tackled in the backfield. 2 yard loss for the halfback.
It's a loss of 2 yards. That'll bring up third and two.
So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go.
Mike 56.
Let's go, D.
He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. A yard, maybe two on the carry.
That makes it fourth and inches.
Set. Ken Boston. Ken Boston.
We've played one quarter. Now this one's scoreless. Set to resume action here in the second quarter, and we're dead even.
Mike 56.
Big opening. And he's tackled right around the 12-yard line.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want enough. They don't want enough.
That makes it first and 10.
Roger. Mike 56.
Now he's scrambling. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. Great call by the offensive coordinator.
Big time play, taking that ball all the way in. Maybe the defense wasn't expecting a run.
And he adds the extra point. So a six-play, 51-yard drive. And they come away with 7 points.
And, Brad, right now the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running lanes.
Florida International to kick. Jackson fields it at the 3, at the 30. Tackle at the 37.
I just love to watch this defense play. They've been flying all over the field today, making big play after big play. The crazy thing is, we still have such a close game despite how well they play.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Out on the screen, through his hands. Well, he tried to thread the needle with that pass.
Well, here the quarterback makes a poor decision throwing into coverage. Needs to look at his progression and find the second and third receiver.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 37-yard line. Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
And they make the stop at the 47-yard line. So it's another third down upcoming here. Throws to the back quickly, off his hands, incomplete.
That is textbook pass defense. As soon as the ball hit the receiver's hands, he was all over.
And they could really put their opponent in bad field position with a good punt here. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Florida International is up 7. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. From their own 21-yard line, second down.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
Third and long now after the sack. Steps out of bounds around the 25-yard line.
That'll make it fourth and six.
Coley awaits the snap. Gets to about the 47-yard line.
Not great, but not bad either. As long as your main priorities are not turning the ball over and establishing solid field position, then you're headed in the right direction.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Pitches it. He's got the corner. Knocked out of bounds at the 41.
Well, he took the pitch there and was able to get the first down. It's a nice option play.
Made at the 28.
With the tackle. That's a gain of 13 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Check 91. 91 is the
mic.
Here we go.
Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked.
Hey, that's a heads up play there by the defender. Get those hands up, and something good may just happen.
From the 28 yard line, it's second down. Fires complete over the middle. And down he goes, right around the 22-yard line.
That'll bring up third and four.
Gets it. He's in space. They'll bring him down at the 18.
Gain of 4 yards. First down.
Level at the 20-yard line.
Well, you can really mess with an offensive game plan if you can take away their ability to run.
Oklahoma State just took their first time out. 2 minutes to go in the half. Gives it off. He's tackled around the 17-yard line. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown.
The things with this defense is you leave yourself vulnerable one-on-one coverage. Great throw by the quarterback and great speed by the receiver.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. And he converts the extra point. An 8-play, 52-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 24-yard line. Right now, this game's got all the makings of maybe being a nail-biter.
Yeah, this game just feels like it's going to go well into the second half, probably into the fourth quarter. You almost have a feel that maybe one of the defenses may have to score a touchdown to be able to win this game.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays.
Let's it fly. And he's taken down at the 45. A nice-looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
He's going to try and scramble, and he's going to be sacked.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
From their own 43-yard line, second down. Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage. He gets gets out to about the 44-yard line.
Pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line. He scrambled. He's taken down at the 42.
At this point, boys, you're playing against the defense and the clock. So you might want to consider to hurry things up.
It deep. Fires quickly and they got it. Touchdown.
The wideout here truly knows what he has to do to contribute to make his team successful.
He makes the PAT. Reese Davis is standing by with this update. Reese,
have a look at what's going on in Durham. And for Texas State, all the ingredients look as if they are starting to fall into place for a potential upset. Every score has had an answer, all locked up at 21.
Touchdown difference in this one, Reese, 14-7. Florida International lines up for the kickoff. Gets to about the 27-yard line. Last drive ended with as good a result as you can hope for, and I'm sure they'd like to replicate that here.
If you can bet, this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
Slings it out there incomplete.
That was textbook coverage by the defense. That's exactly what you want to do on every single pass play, but it doesn't always happen.
From their own 27-yard line, it's second down. Quick pass, brought down at the 38-yard line. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
Lets it fly. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. Pass incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 21-yard line. Hauls it in. Tackle at the 14-yard line.
That makes it third and three.
What a play, and that is first and goal. Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown. That's his second touchdown catch of the game.
You know, this guy is such a difficult target to cover in the passing game. It usually doesn't matter who's covering him. He always seems to find a way to get open and make a catch.
Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. And he tacks on the extra point. Summers gets set to kick this one away. He's out to the 30. He's pushed out of bounds at the 33-yard line. We played a half of football. 14 apiece. We
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Locked up on the scoreboard at halftime and not really much separation in terms of who's had momentum in the game either, David. It seems as if every move one team's made been countered by the other.
Yeah, tick for tack. You score, I score. You hold, I hold. And, you know, this is two great teams going at it. And that's what's – it's always fun to see the chess match go back and forth. And, you know, the momentum swing one way and all of a sudden swing back the other way. But very rarely do you see it go back and forth, back and forth. And now we got it all gridlocked at the half, and it's a good ball game. And it's going to be fun to watch in the second half.
David and I will be keeping an eye on your game and everything else going on in the country here in our palatial and comfortable surroundings in the studio. Best seat in the house belongs to Brad Nessler in Kirk Herb Street.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. Williams takes it at the 8. He's out to the 30. They'll bring him down at the 44. Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful. Makes it to the 47. Fights forward to about the 46. Got it, but he's going to lose yards here. Loss of a yard.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
That'll bring up second and 11.
Quick throw, and he hits him hard at the 44-yard line. That's a gain of 3 on the play. And he's going to be sacked for a loss. This kid just doesn't stop. That's his second sack of the game.
This lineman can overpower anybody on the offensive line. He's the kind of player you have to redesign your blocking schemes around.
Fourth and long here after the sack. They look like they've got the block on, and this offensive line's got to give him some time. I think it says something about the quality of the preparation of both teams that we're into the third quarter and nobody's been able to pull away. Both sides seem to know what to expect. Here he goes. He's to the 40. Gains his way to the 49-yard line.
That's a gain of 19 on the play. First down.
Never had a chance to get any running room. The defense was on him almost as soon as the ball was snapped.
Quick throw out to the receiver. And he's tackled at the 34-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 18 yards. That makes it first and 10. That makes it second.
from the 34-yard line. Second down. Caught, open field. And they make the stop right around the 28-yard line. Evans gained 6 yards with a short completion. Is back. He's knocked out of bounds at the 13.
Call it a gain of 15 yards. First down.
Four down, 91 is the mic.
He's got it with room to run. Tackle made around the 7 yard line.
Gain of 6 on the play. That'll make it second and 4.
Quickly to the tight end. That's a great tackle at the 4. And they'll get him in the backfield. Should be an easy field goal. Oklahoma State is looking to go up by 3. Kicks away, and it's through the uprights.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
They line up to kick this one away. Gathered in at the 6. He makes it to the 25-yard line. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
Check, check. Lion.
Gets out to around the 35. From their own 34-yard line. Second down. Throws complete. He's got room to work. And down he goes at the 46. Out to around the 45. He's at the 20, and he tackles him hard at the 14. Touchdown, Florida International.
Oh, that's a great job and some tough running right there. When you get close to the end zone, things get very tight, and it's tough to maneuver.
And I'll tell you, a 4-point lead is not a comfortable one, especially in a dogfight like this one.
And he adds the extra point. Thank you. National is lining up to kick this one off. Gets out to about the 31. Kirk, you and I like seeing points. We're seeing points in this third quarter. This has been fun.
And I think it's going to continue, Brad. I think the adjustments that were made at halftime have allowed these quarterbacks to go out and really be able to take command of how they want to attack each defense. It's going to come down to that final drive.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. And he makes it out to about the 34-yard line.
That makes it 7-6.
One more quarter of action remaining, and this one has been a real treat. Golden Panthers lead it by 4. Great three quarters of action, tight ball game, and now it's the fourth quarter, and this will decide it. Under heavy pressure. Third and long here in the fourth, and this is the biggest third down of the ball game. Here's a throw. I don't think he got anything on that.
Man, the defense jumped all over that one. No chance to pick up the first down there.
Holly awaits the snap. And he can't hang on to the ball.
I know I'd be nervous with 11 guys sprinting down the field at me, but the first job of a return man is to catch the ball.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Florida International is up 4. He's tackled around the 37-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That makes it 2nd and 8.
Mike 56.
I'm coming.
Texas.
He's going to try and scramble. Decides to slide. The defense stood tall there.
Boy, the defense did what they had to do to get 3 and out and now get the offense back on the field.
Coley is the punter. And he makes it out to about the 37-yard line.
Boy, this has been a fun game to watch, going back and forth and back and forth. It's almost like watching a tennis match here. Whoever has the ball last, my guess, will be the team that wins it.
Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. And he's taken down around the 46-yard line. Got a man complete, and he's hit hard.
Call it a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up 2nd and 3.
Shoot!
at the 30. They'll bring him down at the 20.
Gain of 19 yards. First down.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. Here's the halfback on the screen. He's taken down at the 12-yard line.
On the tackle at the 12-yard line. That makes it second and two.
Runs right for a nice game.
Gain of 6 yards.
Too easy, too easy.
That makes it first and goal.
Some daylight. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That's good for a game on your yards. That brings him second and goal. And there comes his quarterback.
Second down, goal to go. Ball on the two. Now we'll see how the backup can do after that injury. And they hit him in the backfield.
That's got to be very frustrating for that running back. This offense is trying to get in sync and trying to get a rhythm established, and for such a negative play to happen, loss of yards can really have a negative impact on the offense and what they're trying to do.
Here's the eighth play of the series. And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. The five. Brought down around the 5-yard line. So not a lot of time left, and they've got an opportunity right now, if they score, to put the nail in the coffin in this game. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. Gains his way to the 13-yard line. Miller gains around 8 yards on the run. Oklahoma State's going to use their first time out of the half here. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Run, and he's brought down.
The defense can't be surprised that they're running the football, but for whatever reason, they're not stepping up when they need to be able to come up with a stop.
On the run, right side. Tackle at about the 31.
The reason why it's so crucial to be able to run effectively like this is it keeps the defense guessing. They have no idea whether you're passing or running, even if you need medium to long range yards.
We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. From their own 29-yard line, it's second down. And the quarterback's going to take a knee to drain this clock and any hopes the opposition may have had. And so that's going to do it. Our final score in this one, 21-17, FIU. Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.